Greetings. Wow. Yesterday I posted my video, Answers to Islam's Questions Number 2, Describing God. And because it was to be foundational, I did not address the Trinity. I did, however, thoroughly describe that God is love, and cited 1 John 4, 7 and 8. And I challenged those in Islam to produce surah and ayat for the following three characteristics of Allah. In fact, I challenge any Muslim to produce surah and ayat that teaches the Allah of the Quran loves sinners. Allah loves us before we love Him. Allah is love. Surah and ayat, in Allah's own words. And the first poster turns out to be the perfect response. And please do not be offended because I am not mocking this brother. So let's take an honest look at the mind of Islam. You didn't answer the Muslim's question, or you didn't understand what he meant. All what you said about God, we Muslims agree 100%, but I guess the question was to explain the Trinity and the divinity of Jesus, not God, the one God. This is a serious moment, my friend, so I am not even going to mock in a feigned Islamic accent. I don't want to distract you from this perfect teaching example. God doesn't love sinners who don't repent. How can someone love a sinner who doesn't repent? Indeed, Allah loves those who are constantly repentant and loves those who purify themselves. That's Surah 2, 222. God loves us before we love Him? Question. How come? God loved Hitler? God is love? So that was the response, and now let's look through it carefully. You didn't answer the Muslim's question, or you didn't understand what he meant. All what you said about God, we Muslims agree 100%, but I guess the question was to explain the Trinity and the divinity of Jesus. All what you said about God, we Muslims agree 100%. That statement has such a ring of clarity, doesn't it? But it is like much of Islam's claims. Very emphatic, but empty. How can I say it's empty? Well, what did I say that this brother states Muslims agree with 100%? Well, I won't reproduce the whole of video 2 here, but I did provide the description of God in a certain order. I largely started in the Old Testament where the prophets presented the I Am, and worked my way to the God of 1 John 4. Or stated in a slightly different way, I worked my way to the things Jesus could not say, because men's hearts could not grasp them without the Holy Spirit. God is love, specifically God is agape, a Greek word meaning a kind of self-sacrificing love which does not consider itself when it gives to the object of its affection. The essential nature of pure agape, love, both compels and empowers God to do what God has done. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loves is born of God and knows God. He that loveth not knows not God, for God is love. In this was manifested the love of God toward us, because that God sent His only begotten Son into the world that we might live through Him. Herein is love, not that we loved God, but that He loved us and sent His Son to be the propitiation or atoning sacrifice for our sins. God is love expressed to all mankind, in that God does not desire any should perish. God desires that all men should be saved, but God allows free choice in the matter. 1 Timothy 2, 3-4. This is good and acceptable in the sight of God, our Savior, who desires all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. And then I summarized with a challenge for Islam to produce surah and ayat of the same. Because there is such a stark difference between the gospel and Muhammad's religion. All what you said about God, we Muslims agree 100%. But I guess the question was to explain the Trinity and the divinity of Jesus. And I honestly made the conscious choice to not even address that issue in my initial response. And for the moment, I am not going to describe the Trinity here either, because until a man has the Holy Spirit, it is not something they can grasp. But after raising the Trinity as an unaddressed issue, this brother moves on to the meat. God doesn't love sinners who don't repent. And that is when I went, wow! In response to my first challenge, produce surah and ayat that teaches the Allah of the Quran loves sinners? The thinking and heart of Islam is fully stated. Allah doesn't love sinners who don't repent. I could not have stated it more succinctly. This is perfectly clear, and I did not have to put words in a Muslim's mouth. And this brother in Islam is not angry, not cursing me. He really is incredulous I could make such a claim that God loves sinners. You can tell this from his next statement. How can someone love a sinner who doesn't repent? And that is so sincere, so honest. Imagine this man sitting at the feet of Jesus. John 6:32, if you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? Even sinners love those who love them. And even though Jesus said this to us, it also applies to Almighty God. If Allah only loves those who love Him, that is no credit to Him. Allah would be no better than a sinner. Verse 33, if you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners do the same. And if you lend to those from whom you expect to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners to get back the same amount. Luke 6:35, but love your enemies and do good and lend, expecting nothing in return, and your reward will be great, and you will be sons of the Most High, for He is kind to the ungrateful and the evil. You will be sons of the Most High, for He is kind to the ungrateful and the evil. Because He, God, is kind even to ungrateful and evil people. You see, the God that Jesus was a messenger for does love sinners. God does love sinners. But the Allah that Muhammad created in his mind does not. Romans 5:8, but God commended His love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. See, God showed His love while we were yet sinners, before we were repentant, before we purified ourselves. Indeed, Allah loves those who are constantly repentant and loves those who purify themselves. 2:22. But I've just shown you the God of the Bible loves us before we are repentant, loves us before we purify ourselves. But Allah only loves those who purify themselves. We Christians debate whether salvation is of works or faith. Well, here is Islam's answer, and there is no debate in Islam. You earn your entrance to paradise. You repent, you purify yourself. Then and only then will Allah love you. God loves us before we love Him? How come? God loved Hitler? God is love? I don't know about you, but statements like these make my head spin with hundreds of answers. Yes, God loves us before we love Him. In fact, we cannot love God first. If God did not love us, He would not reveal Himself to us. And if God did not reveal Himself to us, we would be secular atheists, absolutely unaware of His existence and unable to detect His existence. How come? That's actually a great question, because it demonstrates God is not a man and does not think like a man. How come is man's thinking? What's in it for me? In the context of God loves us before we love Him? How come? The actual question being asked can be restated. Why would God love us before we love Him? What's in this for God? And that really does ascribe to God the same selfish thinking a man has. Really meditate on that truth for a moment. That really does ascribe to God the same selfish thinking a man has. What's in this for me? As God, what's in this for me? God loved Hitler? Now that is a deep philosophical question. Seriously deep. Deep to the chasm of splitting the body of Christ into Calvinism and Arminianism. Jacob I have loved, and Esau I have hated, kind of deep. Which always puzzles me that Islam thinks Jesus' name is Issa or Esau. Did you ever notice that before? That Islam calls Jesus by the name of the one man that God said he hated? Moving on. God loved Hitler? And I believe, yes, the short answer is yes, God even loved Hitler. Not what Hitler did. It is God's infinite knowledge from eternity past and future which knew what Hitler would do. And whether you like it or not, Hitler was a tool in the hand of God to fulfill prophecy. Hitler was a tool, just as Pharaoh was a tool, just as Mohammed was a tool, just as the Antichrist will be a tool. And the maker of heaven and earth is not subject to your idea of fair and right and nice. God is love? Yes, God is love. And not just God can be nice. The Word of God reveals if you don't love, you shouldn't claim to know God. So there, in one response, the message of Muhammad's Allah is compared and contrasted with the Lord God, Yahweh Adonai, the holy, loving, redeemer God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Now, if you call yourself Muslim, do you, in your heart, in your most inner thoughts, do you hunger for the love of God? Do you think of the love of your mother, and your heart yearn for that kind of caring for you? God's love is better than that, my friend. The message of the true Injil says that God desires none should perish. And God Himself has provided a way to salvation for you. But you must decide, brother. You must accept God's way. God's true path. You must accept the sacrifice of the Son of God. The choice is up to you. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.